We present the news quiz, and here's the chairman, Barry Took.
Thank you, hello, and welcome to the programme which comes this week from Imperial College London. You cheer now. I'm told that soon it will be known as Metric College Europe. However... Oh, yes, it will. And in a week that brought you the NFT index no longer in the pink, we bring you the elusive Richard Ingrams, editor of Private Eye, debonair John Craven of BBC One's Newsround, a return visit by Gay Search, gallantly standing in at short notice for the indisposed Bill Mooney, and, of course, the disposable editor of Punch, Alan Cora. And we begin with our headline of the year, sent to us by Peter Stallwood, who spotted this gem in bold print on the front page of the Bracknell Times.
Legless man flees jail.
Well, let's open round one with Richard Ingrams, who makes his first appearance on this series of the news quiz. Richard, who refused to join the circus as a performing mole?
Is this a politician?
Yes.
Yes, must be if it's a clown. Oh, you didn't say clown. Is it Sir William Rogers?
No. A bit further left of that.
Further left. Yes, Mr. Heffer.
Further left than that, even.
Left of Heffer. Paul Foot. No.
Not quite as far left as that.
I mean, if you go far, you get to the right if you go that far to the left.
Yes, I suppose you do.
No, I can't do this.
Well, I think Alan Corran can. Alan, can
I think this is a retired peer, Lord Stansgate.
It is.
It's our tone. And...
He's very right-wing. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Well, he was... after he came out of the Navy, someone sidled up to him, as they will with sailors, and said, would you like to be a spy? He said, no, I want to be a Labour MP instead. And they all laughed a bit and went away. The man was described as a certain colonel in the paper, and kept on coming back to Ben year after year, which is extraordinary. He must be his only friend. But he kept coming back and saying, would you like to be a spy? And he said, no, I still want to be a Labour MP. And he has now broken the story, blown his cover, in a book which I wouldn't dream of publicising, but it's his new book out this week.
Having failed to become a spy, I think he then joined the BBC as a producer.
That's right. It was around that, yes. There's two marks to Alan there. Go on, proceed.
Well, I was going to say that he was then one of the very few people to be sacked by the BBC because he set the studio on fire. High spirits.
Yes, high spirits. Youthful high spirits. Anyway, Alan gets two. Nobody else gets anything on that one. And John Craven, it's your question. Who hopes to bring down the high-flying highballs?
Now, this couldn't... No, this isn't Django the police dog, is it? It's the... the Shetland pony-sized police dog that licks crime.
No.
I know, it's the airline pilots, isn't it?
That's right.
It's the airline pilots who want people to get their duty-free when they get to their destination and not before they get on the plane.
That's
because
right.
Because they think it's a fire risk, all those bottles of whiskey and vodka being broached in the planes. Is that right?
That's absolutely right. And not only that, of course, the people get violent after drinking and rush up and down the airplanes and go, hello, how are you, bomb, and so on. And the Fosters keep exploding. Anyway. Gay Search, welcome back, and so soon. Now, let's see if you can repeat last week's triumphant victory with your first question. Who was heading for destruction and with a big hand raised the roof?
Ah, yes. This was a team of karate chaps.
Absolutely.
In Worksop, who were asked to go and demolish some derelict pigsties, but unfortunately they attacked a row of houses on the other side of the road. I think it was 120 to 136 Kilton Road or something like that. And with their hands and feet, they smashed them to bits in about 40 hours and created some sort of record for the Guinness Book of.
Yes, I think you've done more than earn your 2 marks. That's all you're getting, but you did more. What it says here, a team of 47 karate experts volunteered to knock down a terrace of 17 houses in, as you so rightly say, Worksop. Although they managed to take off all the roofs, they could only destroy 8 houses. And one of their team, Phil Minor from Sheffield, said,
we have sore hands, heads and feet. six of us fell through a roof.
Now, on the subject of demolition, last week's destruction of the stately home instead of a cowshed led to this misprint in the Times, as spotted by Major R.I.G. Hale.
He was an Irishman in his mid-30s, and he replied, "Oh, no, sir." But I eventually persuaded him he was.
And so to Alan Corrin. But first, a piece of music.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. A woman done left and took all the reason I was working for. You better not try to stand in my way as I'm walking out the door. Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
Well, I don't think you need to be told what that was. The lyrics are quite clear. And the question is, how often did the gang member address that to the leader?
Ah, well, I think this is Bill Rogers, who hasn't done anything good since South Pacific. this week was not offered a non-shadow job in the cabinet that doesn't yet exist, but might if everything goes well for Michael. I think he was offered something like a shadow spokesman on car park outside House of Commons, and said he didn't want it. He was waiting for something bigger.
And didn't get it. But you get 2 marks, and we come to the end of the first round. The scores are Richard Ingram's 0. We have missed you on this programme, Richard. John Craven 2, Gay Search 2, Alan Corrin 4. That's the end of round 1. Well done, Alan, in the lead. Let's open our second round with our thanks to Mrs. Sonia Morgan from Wilmslow, who sent us this tasty recipe for lamb tarragon casserole from the Manchester Evening News.
Place the chops in a casserole. Cook in a moderate oven at gas mark 4 for 112 hours.
Well done, Manchester Evening News. Now, back to you, Richard Ingrams, and another question, and it is this. How is 1/8 making new waves at the Alma Mater? Alma Mater.
Alma Mater, yes. Alma Mater, as we were taught to say it at school. Yes, indeed. I was 1/8 in Alma Mater, Oxford and Cambridge. Yes. 1/8.
Yes.
It is the Lady Cox.
It is the Lady Cox.
The Lady Cox. Lady Cox, who is believed to be the first Lady Cox. well, that's it. The Lady Cox.
Yes, absolutely. You don't know a name, do you? I mean, keep harping on her jobs.
Oh, I don't know the name. What do you expect?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'll just cringe
sorry,
a bit
sorry,
and put
sorry,
down
sorry,
to...
Sorry, sorry about
what
it.
About a point for her name and weight?
Okay.
Yes. Sue Brown?
Yep.
6'7", from Honiton, Devon.
Very good. Well nice. Done. A bonus mark. Brilliant. And you're quite right, Richard. She is the first lady rower.
They're hissing because they feel that people are being too keen about it. And they feel that people have been swatting too much.
Do they? Yeah. They can't be hissing you then. You've got all the points between you. And that is to say, Richard got 2 and Gay got a bonus 1. And John, we move on to you with this query. Who's driving at a heavier burden, but not so as you'd notice?
This is not the Ayatollah, is it? Who's,
not the Ayatollah.
Who's really called Williamson. Did you read that story this week about...
No.
The Ayatollah apparently had a father from Bristol called Mr. Williamson, who was a colonial who went native early this century, but that's not the answer, is it?
No.
It's interesting, but it's not the answer. In Bristol, they add an L, you know, so it'd be called the Ayatollah in Bristol. No, I don't know. Sorry.
You don't know it. Alan does.
I think it's the same as last week's lot. It's the Council for the Demolition of Rural England again. Apparently, a large number of scheduled houses are still standing as a result of very small juggernauts coming over from Europe. So they're going to increase the size of juggernauts to 44 tons, but they won't actually get any bigger. They'll just be heavier and shake more, and more roof rafters will fall.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.